Queena Dadima. Welcome back to my channel. Okay, today's video, I thought I would do weird things that I had to do before a meet. Like, kind of superstitions, but not like extreme superstitions, if that made sense. It was just different things that I had to do before the meet in order for me to feel like I was ready and prepared. You know, I feel like a lot of gymnasts have those kind of things. Like, they always have to do this before they do a meet and all that stuff. So I had like this long list of things that I'm just now realizing it was that long that I had to do before a meet. It ended up being just like a routine to me every time before a meet and went like this. So I'm gonna get into my weird little things that I had to do before a meet. So the first thing that I had to do was I always had to get a mani-pedi. At first, it had to be French tip, clear with the white little tips. But then when I went to college, I could have colors and stuff like that. So I got blues and sparkles. To get my nails done. The second thing I had to do was I had to get 8 hours of sleep. I had to time it. I was like, okay, so if I go to bed at this time and I wake up at this time, I'll have this much time to get ready to walk to the meet or to drive to the meet or all those little things. I calculated every single time frame in my head, so I made sure that I had 8 hours of sleep. So the third thing that I had to do was after I woke up, brush my teeth, all that kind of fun things, I had to go on a run. Whether it was, usually it was between 2 to 3 miles that I had to do. I always felt like it gave me energy before the meet, a big boost. Funny story was one time I was like injured, like I had like a strained hamstring and I was told only to go full out like at a meet and like take it easy at practices and stuff like that. But in my head, if I didn't run, I didn't feel like I was prepared and energetic for the meet. So I woke up one time and it was like super early in the morning. I had my pajamas on because I was like, okay, no one can find out that I ran because I was not allowed to. So I kept my pajamas on, I got up, rolled out of bed and I started running. When I got to like the treatment center, my trainer, she goes, Sophina, I like your pajamas. And I was like, what? And she's like, yeah, your pink and striped pajamas. I was like, oh, no. She's like, yeah, I saw you running. You're not supposed to run. So I got in trouble for that, but I think it was kind of funny. Like, regardless, I really had to do it. So the funny part was she told me if I wouldn't have worn pajamas, my pink striped pajamas, she wouldn't have noticed me. Because who in their right mind goes outside and runs in their pajamas? Me. Was I would first take a shower, wash my hair, get out the shower and do my hair, then I would run a bath water and have to sit in the bath and soak and soothe. I know I was not conserving water with that, but it was a must do that I really, really, really had to do because I just felt like if I did my hair, then it would dry and then I could get into the bath and then I wouldn't do my hair in the bath because then it would get dirty. I was like double clean, hair was clean first, then the body was clean. I don't know. It was like really therapeutic. So yes, every girl shaves and all that kind of stuff, you know, especially as you get older. Now, yeah, shave armpits, all that kind of stuff. I shave that all the time, but for meets, you know, you had to meet every single week, so I didn't let my hair grow for months and months, but at meet day, I had to shave my legs. Like, it was only on meet day. I couldn't shave the day before, the day after, the weekend. I had to shave it on meet day. I don't know, it made me feel like lighter, like not in color, like lighter in weight, you know, like fly like a bird. It just was like, and then like you could like zoom through the wind. You know, okay, like apparently swimmers, they have to shave everything because they'll glide through the water like easier. So that's kind of the same with my mentality. I'll fly through the air easier, if that makes sense. And yeah, and then I just feel more vibrant and just silky smooth. Oh, great feeling. Next, I would do my hair. Now, you guys know me as the blue hair, so first, I always had to have a bow in my hair and I sparkled it, I bedazzled it, it was super bright and just had it, it was so pretty. I went to college, we all had to wear scrunchies, so I had to get my own pizzazz, which was my blue hair. Now, I couldn't go to a meet without my blue hair, or else I wasn't me. So I had to make sure, once I had my hair up in a ponytail, and then sprayed my hair blue, and I was good to go. Okay, so I do have a lot of piercings. I will get into that another time, how many piercings I have, what my piercings are, but you can see that I do have a lot of piercings. I know I've seen a lot of comments about, oh, like she has a hearing aid. No, it is not a hearing aid, it is a piercing. But anyways, for meets, I had to take out all of my piercings, which to me was super extremely annoying. Apparently, piercings are distracting to judges, so we were allowed to have one on each ear. Or you could have one in your nose or whatever, but I had to have one in each ear. Now, I went shopping maybe every year or every few years for certain earrings that I had to wear each time. Perfect. My favorite one, it had like sparkles around it and then a big diamond in the middle of it. And I had them, and they were quite big, but not too big. It was just perfect. I had to put those in and had to make sure I had my earrings so I was sparkling out there on the dance floor, or the meet floor, as we shall call it. Now my makeup, mascara, eyebrows, highlighter, all that kind of stuff, but I had to have my sparkles. You guys already know that I'm obsessed with sparkles. I love sparkles. Sparkles is my favorite color, so it is only right to have sparkles on my eyes as well. So I had sparkle eyeliner. To have at the meet. Okay, so visualization is a big thing. I definitely did a video on visualization beforehand, and I think it is extremely super important. I've been visualizing since I was this big. Okay, so visualizing, guys, just in general in life, whether it's your sport, I think visualizing is just an amazing thing. Your mind is so powerful. So after I was done getting ready, I had to visualize. Last, but definitely not least, I think this is definitely where everything stemmed from. Everything started from this one little weird thing. My oatmeal. Oatmeal. It all started when I was a pee little thing, and my dad made me oatmeal, and he told me oatmeal before meat is amazing, it sustains you, it keeps you full longer, and all like these amazing benefits to oatmeal. So I started eating oatmeal. I ate oatmeal all the time before meats, but then I started traveling to meats, and I started panicking because other places didn't make oatmeal like my dad. But I had to adapt and eat other people's oatmeal, which ended up being fine. But now, every time before me, always have to have oatmeal, and now I have added coffee into the mix. Oatmeal. Coffee. I don't think I will drink a whole cup of coffee, because if I drink the whole cup, I will be a little too jittery, but I probably drink about a half a cup of coffee and my oatmeal. Just an amazing combination, and it is a must before me. Think of it like Popeye. You know, like he always had to have his spinach? Well, that was me. I always had to have my oatmeal. And now coffee. Okay guys, that is the end of this video. I hope you liked it. Make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button. Follow me on Instagram at Sofina the Diva, and on Twitter at Sofina_DeJesus. Please make sure to comment below maybe your weird things that you have to do before your meet or your competition, or just in general. I would love to see it. Maybe we have some things that are kind of similar or in common and what have it. But thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you guys another time. Bye!